we mentioned that one of the functions of the network layer was to route the packets all the way from sending machine to destination machine, no matter where these machines are located and how many hops or intermediate routers are on the way. And so in order to do that, we need to follow some sort of a routing algorithm. We have mentioned before that there's two types of algorithms. The non-adaptive algorithms, they do not base their routing decision on any measures. But the routes are computed in advance and offline, and it's called static routing. And we also have a dynamic routing, which are adaptive algorithms. They will change their routing decisions with time. So we have non-adaptive, which are static routing algorithms. And then we have the adaptive or dynamic algorithms. They get information from the adjacent routers and use some optimization metrics, such as the distance or the number of hops or the transit time in between the routers, in order to compute the best path. When we talk about routing, we need to consider fairness versus efficiency, because fairness and efficiency are two contradictory goals. So for example, if we look here, let's say that the traffic between A and A prime is maximized, and between B and B prime is maximized, then C and C prime. And the traffic is flowing enough to saturate all of these horizontal links here. So if we want to be efficient to maximize the total flow, then we pretty much need to shut off the flow from X to X prime. Now, that is not fair to the flow from X to X prime. So these are two contradictory goals that we have here. So there is some compromise is needed between global efficiency and fairness to individual connections. Router J is on the optimal path from router I to router K, then the optimal path from J to K falls on the same route. That is the optimality principle. If the is on the optimal path from I to K, then the optimal path from J to K falls along the same route. The next picture is showing a thin tree. So if we follow this principle, we can build a sort of a tree for the entire network. The thin tree will show the set of all optimal routes from all sources to a given destination. The root of the tree is the destination. So this is the sink tree for destination B, or rather B, that is at the root. And the distance matrix is the number of hops between the source and the destination. So for example, to reach from B to O, we have the router C, J, and N. They are three hops. From the source to the destination. So optimal principle is router J is on the optimal path from router I to router K, then the optimal path from J to K falls along the same route. And the sink tree is the destination, router, and the tree shows a set of optimal routes from all sources to that destination. The distance matrix is the number of hops